Hell yeah, Dad. It's finally October 1st. That means it's time for spooky season. It's the season for spooky season. Yeah. So how am I going to start this off? Which movie should I watch first? Let's find out. Seen it. Shit. Utter shit. Mega shit. Ultimate shit. God, there's nothing to watch on Netflix. How is there a million fucking movies on Netflix and never anything to fucking watch? Oh, wait. What's this? Hellraiser Judgement. I've never seen Hellraiser Judgement. Come to think of it, I've never really seen any of the Hellraiser movies. Maybe I should give these movies a chance.
1 hour later.
Oh my fucking god, I've made a terrible fucking mistake. Why did I give this movie a chance? You know what? Where's my fucking blazer? I gotta tell everybody about how shitty this fucking movie is and warn them so they don't waste an hour and 20 minutes of their life like I just did. Fuck this shit. Did I just watch? Like, I legitimately did not comprehend what I just watched right now. Like, I have no idea what the fuck did I just sit down, have my eyeballs set fucking view on. I do not understand what just happened. But you know what? Nonetheless, I'm gonna take a crack at it. I'm gonna try my best to try to summarize this film and try to just like review this with my best of my fucking abilities. So tonight, ghouls and gals, we're going to be reviewing Hellraiser Judgement. First off, I want to say, you goddamn right I'm going to judge you, Hellraiser. After the shit that you just pulled, after the shit that I just had to sit through, after the hour and 20 minutes of my life that I will never get fucking back, you goddamn right I'm going to judge your fucking ass. I have a few fucking questions for your ass, Hellraiser Judgement. I'm just strictly talking to you right now, Hellraiser Judgement. It's just me and you. I'm not even worried about the audience right now. I have a few fucking questions I want to ask you. One, what the fuck did I just watch? Two, what the fuck was going on? And three, I thought this was a Hellraiser movie. There was no Pinhead, there was no Cenobites. Instead, what we got was basically CSI fucking Hellraiser. Spent the entirety of the fucking film dealing with this fucking three detectives that are stuck in this melodramatic fucking detective show, and where's the fucking Hellraiser? There's no hell being raised. There's more like fucking melodramatic mid-30s fucking drama being raised in the film. The film is essentially about a fucking army dude with PTSD who has a shitty wife. Yeah, it's about a fucking cuck who happens to be a dude who becomes an army dude who becomes a fucking detective. Like, last time I checked, Hellraiser wasn't about fucking cucks or fucking failed marriages. Like, Jesus fucking Christ, like, I was really fucking disappointed. I mean, I don't really know that much about Hellraiser, but from what I do know about Hellraiser, this isn't what it's about, fucking player. This ain't fucking Hellraiser. This is fucking some lame-ass fucking shit. The only thing that this fucking thing raised was my fucking blood pressure because I got so fucking pissed off at what I was fucking watching. Jesus fucking Christ. Another thing that bothered me about this film was, like, the quality of this film. This film has a very, like, porn-like quality to this film. Like, I felt, like, dirty after watching this film. Not to mention that the entire fucking movie has this, like, brown-like tint over it. It has a literal, like, shit-color tint over the film. And for some reason, there's some person in every single scene wearing brown. I think it's just to signify to you that even the movie knows itself that it's shitty. So throughout the entire fucking film, all I could think about was just like, this is shitty. This is shit. That's shit. This is shit colored. This smells like shit. This must be shit. Oh my God, what is this shit? Oh God, now I know why I don't fuck with Hellraiser. Because of shit like this. Because Hellraiser always pulls shit like this. But I will say, the movie does some things well. I mean, it's effectively gross. And the movie is... yeah, that's pretty much it. That's the only pretty good thing about this film. Well, the special effects are pretty decent. I know the director of this film used to be a special effects artist. And I'm going to give him a word of advice. You need to stick to the special effects chair and don't ever direct another movie again, or at least just don't direct a Hellraiser movie again. I know I'm not an aficionado when it comes to directing or anything like that, but this ain't it, dude. This ain't it. I don't know if you did the special effects makeup in this movie, but that was really good. Maybe just stick to that. I'm sorry, but because yeah, this one ain't it, dude. This one ain't it. Well, I'm Ryan T, and I'll see you in the next one, ghouls and gals. This is